Do you remember learning about water's cohesive property, meaning that it sticks to itself? We learned about this in the water traveling down the string experiment. Are you ready to see some more really awesome water tricks? And you can find a part of this experiment at kidsactivityblog.com, and you can find the link down in the description below. So first, we're going to try something with alcohol. So I have a little bit of rubbing alcohol, and I put it in this bottle just so it's easier for me to get it out. And you're going to want a little dropper. So one drop at a time, we're going to put alcohol on this penny, and we'll see what happens. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Oh, and 20 drops is when it spills. Now, let's try it with water. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, oh. But did you notice that we went through 2 full droppers with the water when we only went through 1 full dropper with the alcohol? There was a lot more water, and were you able to see it actually bubble over into a dome? Why was the water able to do that? So the water molecules stick to themselves, that cohesive property that we were talking about. So the water molecules that are in the middle are being pulled in all different directions by all the water molecules around them. But the ones on the surface are only being pulled inward. So it's a really, really strong pull in one direction. And they pull so tight that it makes like this stretchy skin across the top of the water. And this is known as surface tension. So you can try this with different liquids found around the house. You can try it with oil, with pop. You can try some syrup, you can try sugar water, salt water, and next week we'll be doing it with soapy water. Another fun thing that you can do with this experiment is a contest. So you can try it with your siblings, your friends, your parents, and see whose water dome lasts longer. So just as water's top layer acts like a skin, we also have our own skin. And this helps to keep dirt and germs outside and blood and our heart inside. So these skins are kind of like walls. And do you know what else has a wall? Our hearts. And you have to break that wall and fully let God in. Otherwise, God will just be sitting on the outside looking in. You can pray and pretend like you believe all that you want, but that won't be enough. You have to have faith. You have to break open that wall and let God in so that He can do what's best for you. So don't stop believing. Don't stop learning. And don't stop praying. And remember to let me know what you're praying for so that I can be praying along with you. And I'll see you next Tuesday. So I have this cup full of water, but we're going to fill it even more. So it might be kind of hard to see, but the water level is actually above the cup. And now let's try placing something on top, something that's light and flat, like this piece of tape. And this is how water bugs are able to walk across the water, because they're light and flat, and so they just sit on top of the skin. But if they were to break through, well, then they'd have to swim through the water, and they're bugs, not fish. So I hope you guys have a lot of fun with this experiment. There's so much that you can do. So you can try it with different liquids and test their surface tension. Now water has a very high surface tension, meaning that they hold on really tight. But you can also have fun with your contest to see whose water stays longer on the penny. Or you can even compete with different liquids. Just make sure that you're always having fun and always learning. And if you like what I do, don't forget to like, share, and comment below.